Welcome back. Many pets will eat just about anything. Now, while some objects may be small enough to swallow and digest with minor consequences, others may get stuck and cause your pet some problems. Dr. Edhlund with Gentle Vets is here. He'll tell us what the signs to look for are when your pet may have eaten an object and what to do if they have. Hello. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
So what are some of the items that you should not have your pet eat by accident?
It's really crazy what pets will eat. They'll, one of the things, I've got some things here, the underwear, the socks, the these are the kind of things that a pet will like to get into because they smell of you. Your pet loves you, and pets are very much smell-oriented. And so, you know, socks, underwear, bras, whatever, it's not uncommon for us to have to pull these out. Because they smell them, they smell you, and they say, I want to be part of you. And so they'll eat it, and then they get stuck.
I've never heard of that, because a lot of people do leave clothes, underwear around.
Absolutely, absolutely. You go to bed at night, you just leave your underwear there, and away you go. And it's not uncommon for you to wake up in the morning, and there's your dog with his head laying on your underwear. Hopefully just laying his head on your underwear and not having ingested it.
Oh, wow.
Cloth is really, really bad when it gets in the intestine because it will tie it up. It won't pass. And then the intestine starts to work on it, and it gets clogged up, and then we have to go ahead and remove it surgically. And this is one of the most common things that we have to pull out of dogs.
I never would have imagined that.
Some of the weirder things, another thing is bones.
Okay.
Bones they will ingest, and things that smell of food. One of the strangest things I ever had to remove was 17 rocks that a dog had eaten.
Mm-hmm.
They had poured barbecued drippings on the gravel. And the dog said, hey, this is great, and he ate the gravel. And so he had 17 stones in him we had to remove. Keys, it's not rare to see keys go. The dogs will eat keys.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the weirder things are smelling of food, you know, silverware implements. And I haven't actually removed a knife, but I've seen x-rays of dogs that have had knives removed from their intestine.
Oh, my goodness.
Wires are a common thing for puppies to get into. Now, this is a low-voltage wire, just a USB wire, but they will chew on power cords, and power cords will burn their mouths real badly if they get into a high-voltage power cord.
Mm-hmm.
With cats, one of the most common problems is the string. And string foreign bodies in cats are extremely dangerous. And this is a shoelace, but if they get into any sort of yarn, and there's an awful lot of string toys available for cats.
Mm-hmm.
Do not get them. Strings are really, really dangerous for cats. Again, with the rope toys, you've got fiber. This is not a real good toy, particularly for a cat, if they get these strings out. So these are the kind of things that are not a real good toy.
Okay. But this is a good reason why you should clean up your home. So if wives want to get their husbands to put things away, you can blame the pet.
Absolutely,
right?
Absolutely.
Okay, now are these acceptable?
These are acceptable toys. One of the things that we have to, that I have removed in animals is the old squeaker, and dogs love to get after the squeaker, and they'll tear it apart. Now, this is a good quality toy, and it's tough to pull apart. Depends on your dog. It brings up another interesting point. You would think that a small dog, you want to get small toys. Not so. Get him big toys, because then he can't ingest it.
So what should you do if you suspect that your pet has eaten something?
The primary sign, he's not going to be feeling very good. And he's going to, the primary sign is vomiting. Okay, so you'll notice, first off, he's not feeling very good, and then he vomits. Well, if a dog vomits once, I'm not really worried about it. But if a dog vomits again and again and again and again, it's a really good sign that he's ingested something. It's not something you want to deal with. If your dog has vomited more than twice or three times, there's a pretty good chance that he's ingested a foreign body. If it's stuck in the esophagus, it's very, very dangerous, because the esophagus is a real bad place for things to get stuck. It doesn't heal.
Mm-hmm.
If it makes it to the stomach, which most foreign bodies do make it to the stomach, it's much easier to remove, either with an endoscope or with surgical.
So if they suspect that their pet has eaten something, they're not supposed to take him to the doctor right away.
Absolutely. Yeah. If you get vomiting, if you suspect that he's eaten something and he's vomiting, it's time to get to the doctor, and don't wait. Then we'll do x-rays to see if we can see a foreign body. We may do an ultrasound. They don't always show up very well on either ultrasound or x-ray.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the cloth things, this isn't going to show up real well at all in an x-ray. And so then we need to do barium series. A lot of times we'll give them a barium swallow, which hopefully will further outline the foreign body. And lastly, just going in and looking. If there's a high degree of suspicion, and we don't see any really good signs other than the vomiting and the listlessness, exploratory is a very legitimate diagnostic procedure. Mm-hmm. If we're worried, it's safer to go in and look than it is to let this sit there and destroy the intestine for, you know, a number of hours or days where it's destroying the intestine, they'll die from it.
All right, doctor, thank you so much. This is so interesting. All right, Taizo, time to clean up your home.
Yeah, no kidding.